Do you want to see how easy it can be to take a PDF that can be fillable, fill it out, create a form with it, and make it so that as people submit a form, you actually generate a PDF? Amazing, right? Well, this new feature is now available with Fillout, which is my favorite front-end form software in the no-code space. So if learning about this new feature is of interest to you, stick around. Let's get into it. Hello and welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business and life with no-code tools. Sounds too good to be true, all of the amazing things that are now possible with no-code, and at the cornerstone of that is no-code automation. And if you're not already familiar with this, no-code automation can help you save countless hours. I'm talking 20 plus hours a week of moving data around. If you want to get up to speed quickly with no-code automation, check out my free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll be sure to include a link wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. I want to showcase this really awesome new feature that is coming from Fillout. I'm really excited about it, and I can't wait to actually put it into use. So, first things first, there is a whole page right here. I will share this link wherever you found this video, and you can just drop in your file, whatever that PDF file is. As you see here, I'm converting a PDF to an online form. So I'm just gonna drop that form right on in here, and I'm going to immediately from that create my form. Now, this assumes that I'm already logged in to Fillout. If you're not already, please consider using our affiliate link, which I'll provide around here. Give it a little bit of love back to the channel. All right, now I'm ready to get going here. I've already downloaded the form that I'm going to be using. I've gone to the United States IRS and I have grabbed their W-9 template and I saved it as a PDF. If I were to open this template up, you're going to see that it is just exactly what you would find on the IRS website. I downloaded this just a few moments ago. And so it's basically saying, hey, here's where you'd fill out your name. Here's your business name. You have to check one of these boxes in terms of what kind of organization you are, either a C Corp, an S Corp, partnership, etc. You can drop in the requester's name, whoever requested to receive this W-9, put in your address, your city and state, any list of account numbers, and then either provide your social or your EIN, your employee identification number. And then lastly, you have to sign this thing and date it. So here's why this is such an invaluable new feature. I mean, think about what I would have to do to my contractors, the amount of effort that I make them absorb when I say, hey, send me a W-9. They have to print this document out. They have to fill it out. They have to sign it. They have to scan it. They have to send it back to me. All kinds of nonsense, right? So many different steps. And I'm putting all of that on the poor people who are just trying to get a little bit of work done. Right? What if instead I built a beautiful form, all they had to do was come in and fill out this information, just, you know, type in whatever they need, do a little e-signature for me, and the whole PDF is automatically created. That's exactly what we're going to do. So I'm going to head on back to where I dropped in my W-9 template. This was back on the PDF to online form for Fillout. And you see that next I get to choose my form design. Maybe I want to give it the dark theme. Sure. Let's generate this form. Now you're gonna watch Fillout do a little bit of thinking, a little bit of magic in the background, where it is basically taking that very PDF and it's transforming it into this form. Now, the first thing you're gonna notice is that we got a lot of pages down here. And that's because, again, if I were to go back to that actual form, it's a bunch of noise. I mean, most of this is instructions on how to fill out the W-9. Only the first page is relevant. So I'm going to just right off the bat, get rid of pages 2 through 6. So I'm gonna flip on back to Fillout, and down here at the bottom, if I look at page 2, this is literally just a wall of text. Nobody has time for that. I'm gonna delete this. And I should point out at this point that I am not in any way making any legal statements that this is valid. I am not suggesting that you do this for this very purpose. I am just presenting this as an example to create a form from a PDF. So bear that in mind. No legal stipulations, no legal statements are being made here on this video. So I am deleting these different pages. I am going to focus just on the first page, and you're going to notice that when I go here, I also have the ability to edit the PDF. So let's click on that and see what this is. So what it's already done, it's created the different fields for me in the form, and it's linked them back to sections of this very form itself, the very PDF itself. Now, right here, I have the capability of looking at these different elements, and we see that each one of these things is like linked back to something else, right? So here, if they check off this particular box, this is the individual slash sole proprietor box, then they are designating that they are that kind of a corporation. Now, another way I might want to do this is actually change the field so that when they're filling out the form, they're making a selection in terms of what type of corporation they are. Are they an individual slash sole prop? Are they a C corp? Are they an S corp? Are they a partnership? So maybe I want to remap that, right? So we're looking right here that this is all on that connected field on page 3. So let's actually go back. We're going to exit the PDF designer. And here it is on page 3. We see that that's how it's been put here. Although the way that it titled this, it makes no sense. So instead, I'm going to say what type or what is your business entity? And here on page 3, I'm not really sure why that is an option. So let's go back to edit our PDF. I want to highlight here that this is not 100%. What I'm doing here is just taking a shortcut to get to my final destination. I still need to go back in and make this look a little bit more presentable. So I'm going to actually copy this little section right here, individual slash sole prop. And let me go ahead and exit and drop it in here. Nope, I did it wrong. Individual slash sole prop. Confirm that the next part is C corp, S corp. I definitely don't need this one here. Let's see if I can actually manage all of this back from this very section. If I highlight this, here we go. We see the trust estate is selected right here. We've got, I don't know why it's showing this particular option, the 3 check appropriate box for federal tax. So again, there are just these components that we don't really need, but it's getting us pointed in the right direction. So printer type, I'm going to toss that. I'm tossing this option. The options that I care about right here are individual, C corp. Oh, I do want that partnership as well. So let's drop that in here. And you'll see that when I bring that in, I can drag that little element right over there so that I'm showing it where on the form is that getting filled out. And this is where I would add in that new option for partnership. But you see, I don't actually see it from the dropdown. So let's stop right here. Let's save as we've currently got it. And we're going to go back now. We're going to exit. And I'm going to drop in a new element here. I want to bring in partnership as an option inside of this. So I'll click out of there. Again, I don't want these different options showing up. So printer type, no, I'm gonna toss it. And this is looking a little bit better. Looks like I have a redundancy for my individual slash sole prop. So let's get rid of that and see if I can't go back now to edit the PDF and make sure that everything is mapped appropriately. So here, now I'm saying, hey, this is the option I wanna update and there is partnership. So as you see, again, just a little bit of finagling, little bit of back and forth here. One other thing I want to highlight is that down here we have the social security number broken into 3 different sections, which I don't want, right? It's going to be one long number. So instead, I'm going to need to delete these different sections. I can highlight them like this, select them, and click on delete field. Again, delete field right here. And we can just drag this across, right? So bring it across right here. This is actually connected itself to a field where it's saying enter your TIN. So I'm gonna have to update that. Similarly down here, I'm going to delete the second half of the EIN and I'm gonna drag this one across as well. Now, I do wanna point out that this is going to get a little funky. It's gonna be a little messed up the way the data comes in. It's gonna try to put it across that whole space. You'll see what I mean in just a moment. It's not 100%, but it's getting us pretty darn good. Now, the last component here is the signature, and you'll see that we don't actually have a field automatically created for that. So in order to get this, I need to add a new field, and I can drag this down, bring it over here, and I'm going to set it right here, and then it's asking me to pick a reference. Now, of course, I don't have a reference for this yet, so I need to actually go to the current page, and I can insert a new piece, a new question here to the form. Before I do that, let's add one more field for the date. I'm going to drag this down here and I'm going to bring that. And just like that, I'll now save this. So I need to add a signature and a date to the form. Now that I've saved the PDF, I'm going to exit. I'm going to go down to the bottom of my page and I'm going to add those components to my form itself. I also see another wall of text here, so let me just delete that just to make this a little bit easier to read. And now that I'm ready to add those two extra fields, I will find them here. Now, of course, I'm going to make sure I map the right kind of information, the right kind of data. So I want a signature form. So there it is right here. I'm going to say, please confirm and sign. And then lastly, I'll bring in that date field. And for us, the date picker will suffice, but I'm going to rename this to be today's date. And I'm going to set up a little bit of logic here because I want to make sure that this automatically pre-fills with whatever the current day is. So let me go ahead and bring in a default value here. I'll click on the plus, go down to date utilities, and I'll say enter in today's date, whatever that is. So now whenever they load this form, they're automatically going to see today's date. As of my recording here, this is February 16th, and you can see that right there. Okay, so we're almost done. Let's go back to our PDF, edit it up just a little bit more because I haven't mapped these. You see that they're yellow. They're not yet mapped to an actual field in the form, so let's get that. I'll map it down here. Now that I've created those different form fields, let's go ahead and insert them. So this was my signature field right there. Here is my date field. Let's find it. It was on the current page. Scroll all the way down, today's date, insert. So now I've got everything mapped. Of course, there's a lot of stuff that I did not take the time to properly map, but I want to get to the point where we are actually checking out how this moves in motion. So let's save this. My form is now good to go. It's both edited on the PDF side as well as on the field side. And let's go ahead and publish the form. Now, here's what people are going to see when they access the form. Just like that, we created a URL for this form. They're going to see the part where it's collecting the data. So I can fill out my name, Gareth Pronovost. I can fill out Gap Consulting. Let me get rid of that capital letter. We're an S Corp. Scroll on down. Let's see what else we need to fill out here. I believe that this is the field where we need to bring in our address. So let me pop in my address that I have saved on a text expander. There we go. We could bring in the requester's name. We could do account numbers, etc. I'm not going to worry about all that. Let me fill out the EIN here. And we will confirm and sign. Let's add a signature. Of course, I would also want to make these fields required to make sure that they were filled out appropriately. And lastly, we see that today's date has been pre-populated for us, and I can submit. Now, what just happened? On the back end, this form just created a PDF using that information that I filled out. Let's actually flip back to Fillout now, and we can go to the results panel within this form, and we will see that that was just submitted. Now, this is taken on the exact same file name as the file that I uploaded to create this. It was called W9 template, but we can click on this and actually download or access this template, and just like that, we can go in and see that this information was in fact filled out. So here we go. Today's date was filled out, the signature, etc. We'll notice that I did not properly match that employee identification number. So there was an issue in the way that I mapped those fields, but address showed up correctly. S-Corp got the check and we filled out all the other information, the name, the business name, etc. So everything is working and this is pretty good. Now you might ask yourself, what am I going to do with this information? I just created this awesome PDF. What do I do with it? How do I do anything of value? Well, there's a lot of options that Fillout has made available for us. We're going to flip back now into the form itself. We're going to go to back to edit mode here. And on the ending page, we can scroll on down and see that we have two different options here. Number one, I can add this send response. So we can say, save a copy of your response. We will email you a copy of your submission. So if somebody on your team wants to fill out their information for a W-9 and make sure that they get an emailed copy, add this. Alternatively, we could just add in the download PDF option. And just like that, they can, after submission, they go to this thank you page, and with a quick button push, they can download their own PDF. I'm going to actually include this here. I'm going to publish, and really quickly, I'll go back to this and just fill out some information. This time, I'm just going to pop in my name just to be quick. And assuming that I filled everything else out, I would click submit. And then right here, I get download your PDF. Simple click. It's just been downloaded. I can open it up. We see my name. And of course, we're also going to see the date because it was pre-filled. So as you can see, a lot of opportunity here. Of course, I can also still go and integrate this with my favorite database tool. If I need to store this in Airtable or Smart Suite or some other kind of database tool, I can do that by simply mapping where the fill-out form gets stored. So if I want to keep this PDF on file myself, I can do that too. I know we went really fast in this video. There's a lot to cover here, but as you can see, a very powerful new feature from Fillout. If you have any questions that I did not cover in the video, please be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.